Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October the 29th of 2019, well, it is titled Curiosity Rover Finds a Clay Cache on Mars. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image of the Curiosity Rover that is currently exploring Mars and has been there for a number of years now. And it is able to move around, unlike previous exploration of Mars. Many of the earlier explorations either went from orbit and looked at Mars or landed in one place like the Viking landers and could only explore that small section. Now the Curiosity rover can't explore the entire surface, but has explored and moved around within the Gale crater. And that is the crater in which it landed and has been exploring that. And what is being noted here is the fact that it has discovered some clay. Now, why is that such a big deal? Well, clay is a very common compound here on Earth, and it forms in water. And that is the key now that we found some very rich clay deposits on Mars. And in fact, the highest concentrations we have yet found. That means that Mars likely had liquid water on its surface. And in fact, you'd need not just little bits of water, but you'd need lake sized regions of water in able to get that kind of material to be able to condense out and compact at the bottom of the lake. And so what we may be seeing here is what are the remnants of what was once a lake, that there was actually water here at one point in the distant past. And by distant past, we are talking billions of years ago. Mars can no longer support liquid water on its surface. The atmospheric pressure is far too low, so it can no longer hold liquid water at all. And water would go directly from a solid into a gas now as it warms up. However, in the past, Mars's atmosphere would have been thicker, and it would have been able to have hot pressures enough to sustain liquid water for a while. And of course, we look at liquid water as being one of the necessities for life. So the possibility that life could have been present on Mars. So again, this is one of those places to look and to do those tests to try to find out if there is any sign of very simple life, bacterial-like life on Mars. Now, you may wonder, how do we get an image of the Curiosity rover, of the entire rover? Well, this is not actually a single image. This is actually, it tells us about 70 some images that have been taken, 57 images that have been taken and combined together. So a number of images there, each of them would have had parts of the rover within it. And those are put together to make this version of a selfie to be able to see the Mars Curiosity rover. Now, the thing that would be missing is its robotic arm. That is with the camera to be able to take these images. So the robotic arm would not be in the images because that is what is actually taking them. So bits of that would be edited out. And the rest of it would be put together to give us an image here of the Curiosity rover as it explores Mars and its discovery of the highest clay concentrations yet discovered on Mars, telling us that likely liquid water and standing lakes of liquid water would have been present at some point in the past. So that was our picture of the day for October the 29th of 2019. It was titled Curiosity Rover Finds a Clay Cache on Mars. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Orion in detail. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.